So let us try to code substitution cipher here. For substitution cipher, we have an input file here named ip_file. It has some text. I need to convert this text in such a way so that it is not recognized by the third person. For that, I'll be using substitution cipher. So for that, I need a string of alphabets in which I can substitute the letters. Python provides us with a string named string.ascii_letters. I'll print it. So I'll write print string.ascii_letters. As you can see, we have the letters in lowercase as well as in the uppercase. So I'll be substituting this string in such a way so that it is not recognized. The text present in our input file is not recognized by the third person. I'll be using this particular string for that. So in order to execute the substitution part, I'll write import string. After that, I'll initialize a dictionary called dict. I hope you are already familiar with dictionaries, strings, as well as file handling, because we'll be using all three of them in this particular program. And if you are not familiar with these concepts, I would suggest you to go through the previous videos. Please go through the previous videos and then watch this programming screencast. Now we have dictionary named dict is equal to dict is equal to curly braces. This is how we initialize a dictionary. For converting this particular string to a substituted format, I'll write for I in range length string.ascii_letters. In this particular dictionary, if any letter is at ith position, I'll be substituting it by I minus 1th position letter. It's your choice with which letter you want to substitute a particular letter. Here, if I am substituting the letter, a given letter, by the previous letter, so we will have here A will be substituted by Z, B would be substituted by A, C would be substituted by B, D would be substituted by C. This is how our dictionary is going to work. So I'll write string.ascii_letters at ith position will be substituted by string.ascii_letters at I minus 1th position. Here I used minus 1. You can even use plus 1, plus 2, even minus 2, minus 3. It's your wish. I'm substituting it by minus 1th letter so that you can get a clear-cut idea of how our program is working. It would be easy to observe this particular dictionary. So I'll just print dictionary here so that you can get a clear-cut idea of what is happening over here. So here we have the dictionary. As you can see, capital Z is A substituted by capital Z, B is substituted by A, C substituted by B, D substituted by C. This is how our substitution is working. So we have all the substitutions in this particular dictionary named dict. Now we will use this dictionary dict to convert our input file. For that, first of all, we need to open our input file named ip_file. So I'll write with open ip_file.txt as f Then I'll write while true. I need to read this file character by character, and I need to substitute a particular character according to the dictionary. So I'll take a variable here named C. C is equal to f dot read. Now I need to check one or two things here. First of all, I'll be checking whether we have encountered end of file or not. For that, I'll write if not C. If the file pointer hasn't encountered any character, that means it has reached end of file. So in this particular case, we will print end of file and it will break out of this file loop. And if the file pointer has encountered a C which is already present in the dictionary, if C indict, in that particular case I'll take a string here named data. Please initialize the string data here. How can you do that? You can initialize through double quotes. So we have initialized our string data. Data is equal to dict of C. If C is present in dictionary, in that particular case, data will be equal to dict of C. And if C is not present in the dictionary, then we can't do anything. We'll just write data is equal to C instead of dict of C. Please note the fact that in our dictionary dict, only alphabets are present in lowercase as well as in uppercase. And if in our file some integers 0 to 9 or some special symbols are present, that will not be substituted. So here is an exercise for you. If you encounter a file with some special symbols and integers, how can you apply substitution cipher on that particular file? It's an exercise to you. It's left to you. How can you do that? So here we have the string data which has the substituted file, which has the substituted data. So I'll just print it. I'll just write print data. Let us try to print this. So now we have the data, but the data is exactly like the input file. So there is some error in our program. Here if we are reading the file, we need to supply a boolean value here. So I'll just supply 1 and try to read it. Here we have the substituted file. So here is the mistake. When we are reading the file, we need to supply some boolean value here, 1 here. So as you can see that it has substituted our input file, and this is something we can't read and we can't recognize. Okay, so what will I do here is I'll store this output in a file so that you can get a clear-cut idea of the substitution happening over here. So I'll take another file here named file is equal to open op underscore file dot txt, and I'll open this file in writing mode since we need to write it. And what next we need to do here is I need to write this particular string data in our file. So I'll just write here file dot write, and then curly braces we'll write data. Okay, after we are done with the writing part, I'll close this file. I write file dot close round braces. So now let us try to run this program again. So here we have the substituted text. Let us open the file output file or op underscore file. As you can see here, we have the data in the substituted form. This is something we can't recognize. We can't figure out that this text was actually this, and we have substituted it using substitution cipher. So now we are done with the program. I'll go through the program again. First of all, there is a string present in Python named string.ascii_letters. We use this string for the substitution part. Here we are substituting the letters present in the string by i-1th letter. Here we have, for that we are using dictionary. We have initialized the dictionary here named dict. After that we are executing the substitution part. In this particular part, we are writing dict string.ascii_letters at ith position will be substituted by i-1th letter. This is how we are doing the substitution. Please note that dictionaries have keys and value. In this particular dictionary, keys are the letters present in the string and the values are the substituted letters. I repeat, keys are the values present in the string and values are the substituted letters. After that, we are opening our file, our input file, and we are reading it character by character. For that, we need to supply a boolean variable here, 1, so as to read the file character by character. Then we are checking some conditions here. First condition we are checking here is whether we have encountered the end of file or not. If we have encountered end of file, in that particular case, our program will print end of file and it will break out of this loop. And then we are checking if the particular character present in the input file is actually present in our dictionary. If it is not present, then it will only write the C in data. Otherwise, if it is present, then it will write dict of C, the substituted letter in the data. At the end, we are writing this string data in an output file so that we can get a clear cut idea of how the substitution is working. And then we are printing the data and finally we are closing the file. So as you can see here, we have two files here. This is the output file and this is the input file. Here in input file you can read the text, but in output file is converted to some other text using the substitution cipher, which is not recognized, which can't be recognized by the third person until and unless he gets to know that substitution cipher is used here. So this is how you can code for substitution cipher and convert many more text. I hope this programming screencast was useful to you guys. Happy learning!